kept the coverage tight, plastered to the receivers, and left no real options for him to throw it downfield.
After one, 7-0, EA Sports. Second quarter down, it's our home team with possession, as they've got it with a third down coming up. From the shotgun, it's Mariota to the right side, and he's got more complete. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. It's a gain of four there, and it gives him a new set of downs. On first down, Drake. And a good push up front, and he's able to navigate his way down inside the 30. They pick up 11 in addition to moving the chains. Throwing is Mariota. And he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Taken down for the fifth time this game. Multiple defenders there to get him.
These sacks now, they're starting to pile up, Charles, and that front seven defensively, they've had their way with this offensive line.
And I think at this stage, we have to start thinking about different play calls. We've got to start helping this quarterback out, because the entire game he's been under siege. I don't care what the down and distance, they've got to get the ball out of his hands a lot quicker.
On second down, a run with Hall. Pretty nice aggressive run there before being brought down just inside of the 30. They're back now to the original line of scrimmage thanks to that 8-yard gain. Third down now to follow. Here's Mariota. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And they move this all the way down to the 9. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
Boy, this is a well-orchestrated drive they put together. You think back to how far they were backed up to start things out, but they've gone on a march since then. And now after that completion there, they've got a first and goal.
Now here's a pass on first down that's knocked away and incomplete.
Yes, sir. How about an attaboy there on first down? Got his hand in and knocked it away.
Now Mariota. His throw incomplete.
That one was tipped up in the air and fortunately fell away for the defense, because if the offense is able to grab that one, that's a short little jaunt into the end zone, because there's not enough reaction time off of a tip ball for the defense to rally and make a tackle. They were very fortunate on that play.
And he'll take it into the end zone for a touchdown. Marcus Mariota, a 9-yard touchdown run.
And the Bisons are within an extra point of tying up this ball game.
Nothing like understanding where your escape hatches are as a quarterback. Here he's looking, but he knows he doesn't want to force anything. So when nothing avails itself, he slips past the rushers, takes it right up the middle, and takes it into the end zone.
Point after, right down the middle. And we are tied at 7. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. And this will not be brought out. It's a touchback. The OKC offense ready to set up shop again. Over on the sideline, hoping to hit that reset button between possessions. Last time out, they had to punt it away. This time, hoping to finish this thing off in the end zone.
They go play action. Mayfield.
He'll get this out wide to Penny. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. And what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least 2 first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
So give them 2 yards there on the completion. And now that sets up 3rd and 2. Mayfield to throw it. And he is caught. Finding room at midfield. And he's going to get this into enemy territory at the 45. Well, they were in search of a short gain on third down, and they wind up nabbing over 20 yards.
You don't always expect tight ends to be big in terms of run after the catch, but after that play, he joins a growing band of players that's putting that stereotype right on its ear.
So on the other side of the field now, it's first and 10 as they've got things rolling on this drive.
Mayfield's throw pulled in by Kittle.
Yeah, that's good for a gain of 6, and it's second down.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage. Catch number 4 for him on the afternoon, and it'll give him a first down.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
A first down throw for Mayfield. And that one drops down, incomplete. Good coverage there, forced the ball free, and it's second down. To throw, Mayfield. And he floats one there, incomplete.
That's a big force incompletion there to bring up third and long, and this defense can still salvage a little momentum by forcing them to kick a field goal, because just a few plays ago, it looked like they were headed towards the end zone.
And they're going to get him. He sagged back around the 28. And the defense coming through on third down, a loss of 7 to bring up 4. Now Jake Elliott for the field goal try. This one from 46 yards out. The kick by Elliott is good. And they take the lead here now at 10-7. So they're able to end that drive with 3 points in this one possession ball game.
And ideally, you want to end every drive with points. Most quarterbacks would tell you, let's end it with a kick, right? A PAT, that's number one. Field goal, you'll take. Punts, you really don't want to do that. In this case, they'll take the field goal and get prepared for the rest of the game.
And not much happening on the return as he'll get this to about the 23. Now the Rio offense set to take over. And that last drive, it was all about the ground game, ground and pound.
And I don't care how we're playing the game these days, offensive linemen still want to fire out and smack the guy opposite them and move the football on the ground. They feel better about that. That's what they want to do. That's how they want to play, and that's how they got it done.
Yeah, they got it for a touchdown last drive. Let's see what happens here. Now a second down throw for Mariota. Over the middle, caught by London. And now it looks like we're going to get a timeout here. We've got a man shaken up.
But not what you want to see this late in the season. Medical staff is going to check on him, and we'll step aside for a moment.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. On first and 10, it's Hall. And certainly some style points there on the spin. Not a whole lot thereafter, but still a pretty good game.
Good position to be in here, second and inches.
Mariota. He finds his target, it's Schultz. Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. Catch number 4 for him on the afternoon, and it'll give him a first down.
A lot of tight ends just use their size and their strength, try to occupy some space and kind of body people away and catch the football. But not this guy. He's a refined route runner. Makes me wonder if he took some dance classes in his background with his footwork.
Up the middle they go with Drake. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2.
Offensive linemen love creating space for their guys carrying the ball. But when that guy also breaks tackles and creates extra yardage, they almost feel like he's one of them, and they really embrace him.
Mariota's throw complete there to Perriman.
And he'll be out of bounds as he gets this down about the 21 or 22. On first and 10, here's Mariota.
This one is caught, it's Moore.
And out of bounds all the the three. 18 yards there, and it will be a first and goal.
Drake. He is going nowhere in a hurry as he is going to lose yardage here in a big way.
That really sets him back. A loss of six.
That's a really alert defense there because they saw the heavy look come in from the offense, countered it with extra linebackers who brought a little bit of speed and heft and able to really make a big-time play for their defense.
And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. This has been a long drive. You got to figure a field goal would be a letdown. Can they convert now on third and goal? To throw is Mariota. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
Nice call by the defense there on third down. Just flood the field with extra defensive backs in their dime package. Nowhere to go with the football. Forces the incompletion.
And his kick is good. And that will knot us up at 10. That drive took him inside the 10. Good job defensively to hold him to 3.
Yeah, I like how you did that. Give a little tip of the cap to the stop troops there because they didn't give up a touchdown in that situation, right? Made them kick the field goal. And, yeah, points went against them, but that feels a whole lot better running off the field.
The OKC offense ready to set up shop again.
And last time able to get 3. It's not what they wanted. They wanted 6, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. Just I like the way you even described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for 6. Now a second down throw for Mayfield. Connects with Kittle underneath. 5th catch of the afternoon, and that gives him a first down. 5th catch of the game for him there.
Yeah, and the tight end position is now becoming a volume pass catcher. Used to be occasional, right, safety valve, throw one to him every so often, but mainly they want him out there to block. Nowadays, an integral part of the passing game, and they create such great mismatches that they often become the leading receiver.
Ball on the 39. Here's 2nd down and 8.
Mayfield down. Throw to the right here to Gordon. And he is going to lose yardage here. It'll be a loss of 2, maybe 3 on the play. And that's going to lead to a 3rd and 11. Now Mayfield. Pass taken in by his big tight end. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35.
A brief pause in the action here as they tend to an injury. That's George Kittle shaking up on that last play.
So on the other side of the field now, it's 1st and 10 as they've got things rolling on this drive. A throw there, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Devontae Smith, the intended receiver.
And now it's 2nd down. And again, it's Mayfield. Smith catches left side. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. A gain there of 21 yards.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just going to ask you, that wasn't the primary target. He's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage, knew where the pressure was going to come from, and said, I know how to beat that, and that's what he did.
Throwing on 1st down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
Once you get into the red zone, space is at a premium for receivers to try and operate and shake themselves free. That one's incomplete.
Mayfield looks to throw. Over the middle, and it's incomplete.
They haven't been able to stop them so far this series, but getting a nice little stand from their defense now.
This offense was on the move. Now 2 straight incompletions have them looking at 3rd and 10. Play fake. Mayfield. He'll be hit and taken down at the 21.
Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next.
The kick by Elliott is good,
and they will take the lead at 13-10.
So the field goal there caps what winds up to be an 11-play drive.
Well, partner, that's a lot of offense to run there to only get 3 points. So I just wonder, are they going to recycle those plays because they were successful in getting three? Or do you go to another section of the playbook trying to find ones that get you into the end zone and get you six?
And the tackle going to be made right there at the 25-yard line. Now the Rio offense set to take over. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
Second down, Mariota. Now throw right side here, going to be incomplete.
This defense has passed its first two tests by forcing back-to-back incompletions. They know that there's probably another throw coming on third down. Let's see if they decide to force the issue by sending people on a blitz.
Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. And on fourth down, on is the punt team sending this one away. Now it's Lockett. Well, let's gaze our attention as the offense takes the field on Rashad Penny. We're in the second quarter. They've got the lead. The lead, though, not so much because of the ground game, because of their air attack, Charles.
So what they're seeing so far is the possibility of things loosening up later in the ground game. Through the air first, maybe they have to start respecting that even more as the game goes on, and then there will be running lanes to find later.
Yeah, trying to get him more involved here on this drive, maybe. And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
Now a second and 10. Here's Mayfield. Pressure comes and down he goes.
Now a second timeout called for by the defense as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. Now the defense will burn their third and final timeout. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward.
The Rio offense about to set up shop once again. It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You could never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
Now here's a pass on first down that's knocked away and incomplete.
Here's second and 10.
From the shotgun, it's Mariota. And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's third. These guys have punted 4 times already, and they're staring at a fifth, barring a conversion here on third down.
Straight ahead is Hall.
And he's going to get this to about the 20, but that is well short of what he needed.
And hold on here, because on that last run, it looks like we have a player who was shaken up. Always unfortunate to see an injury, especially this close to the end of the regular season. We'll step aside.
So they're forced to punt on fourth as this one's away. Fair catch called for and made at about the 32-yard line. So possession goes over here on the punt.
And it will be first and 10 as they take over.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Mayfield looking for Lockett, and he's got him working his way free across the middle. Now another timeout called for by the offense as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play.
Here's second and 7.
Throwing, Mayfield. Oh, he'll want that one back. Incomplete. He doesn't drop too many in that department. Third down. Mayfield to throw it. Pass incomplete, but the flag in the backfield, and this might be a roughing call.
Personal foul, roughing the passer, defense.
A bad time for a roughing penalty, and they get the gift of a first and 10. They're going to look to throw. And incomplete on the deep ball.
And that's the knowledge you gained from being in this league for a long time. He's learned the hard way when to give up and fight another down. And that's a smart move to throw it away.
Throwing again, Mayfield on second and 10. Throw here taken in by Wiley, the tight end. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. Now here's a timeout as they're going to get it with 8 seconds remaining here in the first half. Here's Jake Elliott. Career long, by the way, for him, 61 yards. This officially a 55-yard attempt. And this one is no good. He missed it. And that will keep this a 3-point game.
Yeah, 55 yards is anything but a gimme. You've got to really concentrate on your leg swing and proper technique. This time, though, he's unable to convert.
Check pink. Smith red. Black one. Final play of the half here, Mariota. This pass is caught by London. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. So that would have been something from that distance, but to no avail. Comes up empty as we have reached the intermission. As we are off to Orlando now to check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach?
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. The weather might be cold, but the playoff races are heating up here on this final Sunday before Christmas. So let's get to it. We'll begin up the coast on Chesapeake Bay in Virginia Beach, Virginia. And it's the Voyagers who have the lead in that one. The Voyagers trying to finish that one off and claim victory. Next, we head off to check out another game. And you can see they are out in front in that one. Malik Willis with a couple of touchdown passes there. We saw a strong first half from the veteran running back, Rashad Penny. He wound up finding the end zone on a touchdown run to help give his guys the advantage here at the break. This one's been as good as advertised. Just a field goal separating these two teams. This was a very level first half, and I'd expect to see more of the same after the break.
From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And he'll be dropped at the 21-yard line. So bringing it out of the end zone proves not a good decision. Loses him about 4 yards. This offense ready to go to begin this third quarter. This offense set to begin the third quarter. And, Charles, if they had a checklist of things they wanted to accomplish in the first half, certainly at the top of that list would be having the lead. And they've got that here.
That's always the most important box to check.
There he goes, left side. And he gets this to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. The catch and run pays off to the tune of 35 yards.
It doesn't look like this defense found the magic elixir at halftime. This offense was rolling in the first half, and that's continued here in the third quarter. Another big play right there.
So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. To throw, Mayfield. It's complete to Lockett. It'll go down as a gain of 6, and that'll make it second down.
That's a pickup of 6. Brings up second and 4 at the 38-yard line.
Mayfield on play action. He's got this to Pickens. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. And now it looks like we're going to get a timeout here. We've got a man shaken up. But not what you want to see this late in the season. Medical staff is going to check on him, and we'll step aside for a moment. From the red zone now, Mayfield. This is caught. And he's brought down. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling.
I think he has to be saying to himself, how did that not wind up a touchdown? Remember, he just did the tip of the ball to cross the plane. It's not going to get there, but they're going to be set up in great shape with first and goal.
Once more, Penny. And forget about finding a lane. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. And they'll let the fullback try and take him home. And he is into the end zone for a touchdown. It's the fullback with his fourth rushing touchdown of the year. And the Blues take the opening kickoff of the third quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead.
And they just powered it in right there, Charles. Three tight ends out on the field, the fullbacks for the defense, they knew what was coming.
They knew, but they weren't able to stop them. They knew they had to meet them with a little bit of force. But on that play, the big guys up front won the day.
Elliott good on the extra point, and his guys will take a 10-point lead. That time, a 6-play drive, and it ends with a 3-yard scoring run. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. And we'll see a return here from the end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. And their deficit a little wider than it was at halftime. Does that touchdown a minute ago change the thinking here at all?
I think it does, at least a little bit, because now urgency has to start setting in. You can't go out there and go three and out and run the risk of falling behind substantially, but you have to do it without pressing, because pressing, that'll lead you into bigger errors.
On second down, Mariota again. And he's got the hook up to Moore. And the stiff arm made it a pretty little run, not a huge gain, but a nice chunk of yardage. These guys have punted 4 times already, and they're staring at a fifth, barring a conversion here on third down. Now a run up the middle with Drake. And he gets it to the 34, good enough for the first.
I don't know about you, but that almost felt like old-time football there. Third and two is not necessarily just a running down anymore. A lot of times they want to throw the ball. They went back to the roots and powered forward and got the first down.
First down, Mariota. On the throw, led him too much that time. It's incomplete.
One thing I have learned, receivers don't mind high throws so much to the sideline, but do that over the middle to them, and not only are the DBs going to throw a little verbal trash their way, when they get back to the huddle, they're going to have a few words to say to their QB, aren't they?
Yeah, hung out to dry a little bit there on the high throw. Luckily, fell incomplete.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Throwing is Mariota. And that will be incomplete as well.
Looks like another empty possession offensively. And you're at that point in the game where you can't afford too many more of these. So this is going to require some heavy thinking on the sideline to figure out what they can do to crack this defense.
On fourth down, the punt team is on as this is sent away. So a change of possession here on the punt. The OKC offense ready to set up shop again. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them. They feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go-around.
Credit that sack to Travis Jones.
This is a little hard for me to compute because I'm watching sack after sack happen, but somehow they're still behind in the game. I would expect all of this defensive pressure to translate to them taking a lead, and thus far, it hasn't happened. Time's winding down. They don't want to waste this type of performance from these ace pass rushers.
Second down, Mayfield. That's to the tight end, Wiley. So the completion results there in 9 yards. And that brings up third and a full 10 yards. Mayfield down. He's got his target. That's complete. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. And they're able to convert on third with a solid gain of 23. On first and 10, Mayfield. Pickens on the slant. And he'll be corralled out across midfield down to the 45. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down. Mayfield with it once more. It's caught, Lockett. And this winds up a gain of 4 to the 41.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
On second down, here's Penny. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25. 61 yards rushing for him now as he's run it 11 times.
Some big plays in the passing game on this drive, and here's one out of the running game. So the passing game loosening things up. Now there's room to roam.
Mayfield now looking to throw on first down. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. Down he goes at the 23, a pickup of 4. Second and 6. Mayfield looks to throw. Pickens makes a sideline grab. And he is out of bounds, but first he gets it inside the 10 to the 7. That one goes for 16 yards. It sets him up first and goal. From the shotgun, it's Mayfield. And it's caught. Touchdown. Josh Wiley. His second touchdown on the season. And his guy's now an extra point away from taking a 3-score lead.
For good reason, quarterbacks want to get the ball to the perimeter to their wide receivers for big plays. But in this situation, it felt like, based on coverage, he knew that he wanted his tight end to have the football, and for good reason.
Elliott now to add the extra point. And that'll make this a 3-score game as the lead moves to 17. A good drive that time as they go 9 plays in all. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. Oh, a good-looking return set up here. And he'll return this one all the way onto the other side of the field.
We all know that teams never want to use the word panic, but if they expect to win this game, it has to start right here, right now. That return just set them up for points, and it needs to be a touchdown, not a field goal.
Now the Rio offense set to take over. I kind of feel like they've reached a do-or-die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback, it has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand they've got to move the ball and move it fast. In addition, they need to save as much time so they can get 2 more possessions.
Ball on the 40 now. Here's second down and 3. Hall on a give up the middle. And a good job of finding the open space to run as he's down close to the 30 here. It's a first down on a gain of 10.
First and 10 at the 31-yard line.
Here's Hall again. Ooh, the juke. Touchdown! Brees Hall, 31 yards. And the Bisons are able to cut into that deficit. So there you go. They needed a big play, and they got one there on the touchdown run.
And that was a very important drive. Of course, they all are when you're trailing in the second half. But what I really liked, they didn't panic. They knew they still had time to run the football and keep playing their game.
An extra point attempt to follow here. And the lead is trimmed down to 10.
So they only needed three plays on that drive.
And it was capped off by a Breece Hall touchdown run. And he'll take it a yard or so past the 20, called it the 21.
Baker Mayfield leads the offense out for their next possession.
Last drive, surgeon-like, dare I say, 7 for 7. That'll help your QB rating.
It will indeed, won't it? Can you figure out QB rating? Can you do it?
Can you
do the formula?
No, I just know the higher the number, the better.
Yeah, that's what I've been
told,
too.
That's what I know.
I know that in the NFL, 158.3 is the number they're all trying to get to. I think he was that on that last drive.
Ball at the 23, second and 8.
Here's Mayfield. Oh, there's that man again. It's complete.
So give him 5 yards there on the pitch and catch. And now it's 3rd and 3.
Now Mayfield.
That's complete to Turner.
And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. Give him 6 yards, and they do convert on 3rd.
From the 34 now, here's 1st and 10.
Throwing, Mayfield.
And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. The end result, 21 yards.
I'll tell you what, a lot of those mid-range throws have been available because sometimes teams get too concerned about the deep ball and they leave too much space in front of them, and these guys have been taking advantage so far.
So on the other side of the field now, it's 1st and 10 as they've got things rolling on this drive.
Excellent job pushing through tacklers that time to pick up 6.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, gotta like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely. Pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
Meanwhile, Mayfield throw into the hands of Pickens.
They have certainly looked his way in this 3rd quarter. Another catch, and it's good for a 1st down.
And, partner, they're locked in man coverage out left, and they end up running a crossing route. Rounded it a little bit more than a slant. He's just going to angle himself towards the right side of the field, and that's very difficult for a defender to shadow him across all that ground.
Meanwhile, the throw here is complete.
2 yards on the pickup there, and that's going to bring up 2nd down.
Brings up 2nd and 8 at the 23-yard line.
They go back to the ground now with Penny. And able to get about 3 as he's taken down right at the 20.
That run wasn't a big breaker, but I don't think the guys on offense mind very much. They've got a nice drive going, and they might just be luring the defense in a little bit. They could probably come back with a play action, maybe go over the top. But right now, on this drive, their playbook is open.
And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal.
And I'll tell you what, this offense is playing a little bit of keep away right now. They've come out here in the 3rd quarter, possessed the ball for quite a while, and they keep on converting. Nice pitch and catch there to set up the 1st and goal.
It looks like a jumbo set with 3 tight ends here for 1st and goal.
They'll try and run for it with Penny. Stays on his feet, and he's going to ball his way down to about the 1-yard line.
78 yards for him on the ground now, as he has been terrific here this afternoon. Penny. Touchdown.
Well, this offensive line has really stepped up to the challenge here because those Mastodons, they've been sensational clearing holes all game long. And this is great work down here near the goal line to give their back the space he needs to work his way into the end zone.
Elliott on for the extra point. And that'll make this a 3-score game as the lead moves to 17. So that one, a long 11-play drive. And it's finished off by a Rashad Penny touchdown run.
They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. Now the Rio offense set to take over. As this offense comes back out here, Charles, they're trailing in this ball game. And they've been on the sideline for a while. They did score their last time out, but they just had to watch that long, sustained drive. So we'll see if they can shake the rust off.
Yeah, and that's always a question that you have when you have to come off the bench after having sat there for a long time. Are you ready to go? Are you loosened up? But even more so, are you mentally alert and ready to put your best product out there?
Now a second down throw for Mariota. A short one going to be taken in here by Schultz. Fifth catch of the afternoon, and that gives him a first down. And they're not going to get to the line to run another play. So we will switch ends as the third quarter has come to a close. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. Back now here on EA Sports, as we're about ready to rock and roll for the fourth and final quarter. Mariota on first down. Over the middle and complete to Moore. And that'll be good for 8 yards to the 45. Ball spotted at the 45. Here's second and two.
At the 45-yard line.
Mariota. Looking for Perriman there. He's got him. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down. Hard to believe his first catch of the game defensively. They bottled him up. That's why they're well on their way to victory.
Put your best cover guy on him and then change the coverages behind him throughout the game. Brackets, double, zone, man, you name it. Make sure he gets a lot of angles.
From a couple of yards beyond midfield, here's second and eight. Here's Mariota. He's got this one complete to Perriman. And he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds. Following the play now, they're going to stop the clock here as a man is shaken up. Always unfortunate to see an injury, especially this close to the end of the regular season. We'll step aside. Working out of the gun, Mariota. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. 21 yards there on third down.
Well, I can put my defensive cap on right now, and I know they're saying don't give up any big plays now. They've controlled this game throughout, and all they want to do is see it through to the end. I think they let their guard down a little bit with that last completion. Sometimes when you're trying not to give up bigger plays, you don't react as fast as you should on other throws.
Kyle Duggar up to make the tackle.
Not too many offenses want to turn down long drives, but when you're down what they are, they've got to pay it off with some points.
Mariota to throw it. And he's wrapped up, taken down, back in the 25. It'll go in the books as a 7-yard loss on the sack, and it's third down. Here's a give to Hall. He juked him, and he's going to get this to about the 20, but that is well short of what he needed. Call it a gain of 5, fourth down now.
I think we all suspected that they were going back to him after he found the end zone on his last carry, and they kept the positive momentum going there. Another nice run by him.
So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. This will be a 37-yard attempt. And his kick here is good. And that will close the gap down to 14. Well, with that field goal, you can argue they needed to get back within 2 scores, and they did indeed do that, but still a pretty uphill battle.
Still going to take 2 fourth-quarter touchdowns to get back into it. And as you and I know, that's a tall order against any NFL defense. They're going to need their own defense to make some plays as well to give them an opportunity.
The OKC offense ready to set up shop again. Well, there are two scores on the plus side. Still time here in this fourth quarter, but maybe you start thinking about playing keep away?
Yeah, I think here's the situation. You're not thinking touchdowns anymore. You're just thinking first downs to keep up with your theme there, playing keep away.
And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And they rattle off a big one. 41 yards.
And this is seemingly how it's been all game long. This defense has been just a step too slow. And here they're burned again. Another big play.
So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. Working out of the gun, Mayfield. And this throw a bit late as he couldn't reach back for it.
Well, he certainly thought he had an open look beyond the first down marker to his receiver, but they just couldn't connect, and that will send them back to the drawing board.
Mayfield now on second down. This complete to Lockett, and they move this all the way down to the 9. That one goes for 24 yards. Well, normally you might say start running the football. You've got the lead here in the fourth quarter, but the way that they've passed it with such success, I don't know, maybe keep throwing it.
Yeah, I think you brought up something that goes against conventional wisdom, right? In this stage of the game, you would think you would switch to a running attack, but you're exactly right. They've thrown it so well throughout the game, and trusting this quarterback, I think he continued to do so.
The 6-yard line, the line of scrimmage on second and goal. To throw, Mayfield. Now a quick throw there, but it's going to be incomplete. A lot of tired bodies on that field, but this is a big play, third and goal. Mayfield to throw it to the goal line, but it's incomplete.
He has just not had his focus in this game. It's not one drop. It's not two. That's 3 for this contest.
Yeah, uncharacteristic for any NFL receiver, and he's no exception. The kick by Elliott is good, and that will extend their lead even further. So that almost certainly the final piece to this puzzle, a 3-score lead. I don't think there's any coming back from there.
Well, you know, normally I'd get on you for giving up on the game right here, but I do think you're right in this case. This late in the game, 2 scores is tough enough. 3, I'm with you. That seems out of the question.
Now the Rio offense set to take over. It's now appearing that this losing streak is going to continue. You know, the coaching staff was confident that this was going to be the game to stem the tide, but that just has not been the case. First down, Mariota. Over the middle, caught by London. He'll be dropped after a gain of about 6 across the 30 to the 31. They'll come up now 2nd and 4 from the 31. Now Mariota. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down.
It's now 3rd and 4.
Throwing, Mariota. Mariota had an 87-yard run as a rookie. This one a bit less, but it is a first down.
That's good for a Rio first down. First and 10 at the 42-yard line.
Mariota. And he slings one that's incomplete. At this point, down big, you'd have to imagine this defense, they're just going to sit back, blanket the field as best they can.
Yeah, this is actually the easy part of the game for them because, just as you noted, they can sit back, keep everything in front of them. But they've blanketed the field the entire game using a variety of coverages.
Mariota's throw taken in by London. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. So on the other side of the field now, it's 1st and 10 as they've got things rolling on this drive. To throw is Mariota. A short one going to be taken in here by Schultz. Call it a gain of 3 on the play, and it'll be 2nd down.
Brings up 2nd and 7 at the 45-yard line.
Opposite, green, blue, check, pin.
They'll throw again, Mariota. He's got the connection to Moore. They call his number again. It's his 6th catch and a 1st down.
That's another
to throw Mariota. And he'll go right back to Moore, complete again. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down, second and right at a yard. And now it looks like we're going to get a timeout here. We've got a man shaken up.
But not what you want to see this late in the season. Medical staff is going to check on him, and we'll step aside for a moment.
Second down, Mariota. Throw left side, there's 9 to 15 he goes. 12 yards there as they keep this drive rolling. It's another first down.
A handoff for Hall.
And the big boys up front, they're going to stop him right at the line.
Brian Brzee, the man to bring him down.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. Throwing is Mariota. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
Incomplete. Greg Newsom on the coverage defensively.
Yellow, opposite, green, blue, check.
Here's Hall. And this play goes nowhere, losing yardage back to the 15. That'll make it fourth down after a loss of 1.
And that's exactly what offenses try to avoid by using motion and throwing different formations up. They hate when he can draw a bead on the play, get a running start, and make a big play behind the line of scrimmage as he did just there.
Desperation time, Mariota on fourth down. And a flag comes in as that one falls incomplete. Well, let's see who this is on.
Offense.
So illegal touching, Charles, on the outside.
And a lot of people wonder if the quarterback should see that. No, it's not his job to understand if the receiver's inbounds or out of bounds. You'd expect him to be there. But if he takes a step out, he essentially becomes ineligible. And that's not a tough one for an official to see, especially one standing on the sideline.
Brings up second and 10 at the 16-yard line.
Now a second down throw for Mayfield.
Quick slant here to Smith.
Mayfield on third and 2.
That is caught.
He's got the first down and more. And finally brought down at the 31-yard line. It's a big play there on third down. 46 yards.
No let up in this passing game. They've been a well-oiled machine throughout. And I actually saw a few guys on the sidelines at the end of the third quarter doing the old hold up four fingers college sign, meaning the fourth quarter is ours. And they certainly weren't kidding.
So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. Here's Penny on the counter. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. What a difference a play makes. A huge step forward and now a small step back as he loses a yard or two. Looking at a second and 11 now after the loss. Now they'll run it again with Penny. And he is not going to go anywhere. They're going to get to him behind the line, and that is going to get us to the two-minute warning. So it's our visitors with a football as we get you reset. They've got a third down now as they look for one more first down to help salt this one away. Inside handoff, Penny. And he is going to lose yardage here. That'll back him up 2 yards and also bring up fourth.
And they have just not been able to block him at all throughout this game. Seems like every other play, he's doing something in the backfield. Already got 2 sacks, and now here's a tackle behind the line.
Now Jake Elliott for the field goal try. From the right hash, this from 53. The kick by Elliott is good. So that, Charles, a season long right there.
And you know who's really excited about that? The special teams coordinator, because he's the one who has to tell the head coach in pregame, this is what we trust him from. This distance, he can hit it, and he repaid that trust by knocking that one right through.
And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21.
Now the Rio offense set to take over.
Well, this game, it has had no shortage of offense. They've been able to put up a decent amount of points on this side, Charles. They just have not been able to keep pace with the other offense they're going against here.
Yeah, it's a good way of pointing things out, because now it's not a total loss, because as you said, they've scored some points, so there's some plays they can build on, moments where the game plan actually worked.
And that's caught inside the 35.
Now they got to get to the line quickly.
A first down throw for Mariota. And it's caught. Touchdown.
Sky Moore. 28 yards.
And the Bisons have got it back to a two-score game here in the fourth.
Extra point right down the middle. And that cuts this lead down to 13.
So two scores down. Time definitely not an ally. But here comes the onside kick.
And this is going to be recovered by the hands team. And that should just about put a capper on this one.
They knew they needed a miracle. They had to have that onside kick. They didn't get it.
Well, as we knew, even before they put the toe to the leather on that one, their chances of getting that done, slim and none. And I do believe we saw Slim just leave the door, didn't we?
We did indeed. I think we're down to none.
The OKC offense ready to set up shop again. And three timeouts remaining here defensively, but really not much reason to use them at this point, as this one is all but over.
If they use the timeouts here, it's strictly for show.
We got a plane to catch.
Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts, as they'll stop it with a little over 30 ticks to go in the football game. And to the 36-yard line, taken down there after getting 8 yards. Now a second timeout called for by the defense. Mayfield from the gun on third down, as the clock stops with 23 seconds to go in the game. Now the defense will burn their third and final timeout. And as the two teams talk it over on their respective sidelines, we take a break.
Now the Rio offense set to take over.
They have a little bit of time left here, but this one not going to go their way.
And this is where, in this situation for me, you just go ahead and run out the clock, shake hands, congratulations, and move on. Because now you're not going to make up for what's happened during the game in this last sequence.
We'll see what they do here in this last sequence. Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
Not only did he have a chance to scan the field there, it felt like he had a chance to scan it twice. The protection was that good. Unfortunately for him, the coverage downfield, equally good.
Here's Mariota.
In trouble here, and down he goes. Back at the 8-yard line.
Well, this was a very close ball game at halftime, Charles, but in the second half, that offense kind of kicked things into another gear, and they were able to pull away for the victory.
And Brandon, I think they're the type of team that just looked in the mirror and said, hey, ton of pressure on, but we're the type of team that can flat out handle it. They stood up with confidence, and made it happen for a victory.
So for Oklahoma City, it's a good fifth win for them as they play out the string. And they'll get another road date next week.
Meanwhile, for Rio, they fall under 500 now as they drop to 7-8.
And they will try to get back in the swing of things next week on the road. And for Charles Davis and our entire crew here at EA Sports, I'm Brandon Gunton, saying so long, everybody.